Hello. Welcome to my channel. I am a tutor. My videos are mostly for beginner PC users. Microsoft is preparing the first major Windows 11 update. The latest insider version is available and being updated. Is there anything in there worth seeing? Let's take a look at some of the updates. Opening up the system information. This computer is running Windows 11 Pro 22H2. This build 22621.1. Maybe by the time you watch this video, it will be newer. Or maybe the official, non-insider version will already be out. I'll take a look at this one. At the beginning of the video, we've already enjoyed the wonderful new blot that is supposed to replace the spinning dots of Windows 10. Many of the innovations of Windows 11 suggest that today's Windows 11 developers have adopted one simple trick. They removed some of the successful and needed features that were in Windows 10. Now they're starting to bring them back little by little. There are several such updates on the desktop and taskbar. But let's start with the default browser example. In Windows 10, you could switch the application to default with one button. In Windows 11, the button is gone. Instead, we were prompted to select file types from a long list. And now, in the latest official updates to 11, the button suddenly appeared. It will probably remain in the official release, and the user will be able to quickly make it default downloaded Google Chrome. Back to the exterior. In 22H2, it will be possible to drag and drop the app onto the taskbar. You won't be able to do it from the start menu. But if you open all apps, dragging and dropping will create a shortcut. You can drag and drop frequently used apps quickly. And just as quickly, you can detach them from the panel. There is also a tricky drag and drop. When you have a document or other file on your desktop or in a folder, you can drag and drop it into the open application that handles that file. It's not very clear. Let's use an example. Suppose I was working with Notepad and I minimized it. I have a text document on my desktop. I can drag and drop it onto the Notepad thumbnail. But if I let go here, nothing happens. You have to tap the thumbnail and when the window unfolds, drag to it. The file opens. I'm sure someone is really looking forward to this update. There are changes in the start menu. Here, as you know, there are two main areas, the pinned apps and the recommended apps and files. If you open the menu and right-click on an empty space, the start settings appear. At the top of the window, there are three settings layouts. You can adjust the size of the pinned and recommended areas. The first setting will make more pinned applications at a minimum of recommendations. The second setting is the default. And the third setting will make fewer pinned apps and lots of recommendations. If you make more pinnings, the recommended became the minimum number. Now you can create folders with applications here, with a simple drag and drop. If you click on a folder, you can run apps in it. You can also assign a name to a folder. I click here and enter an invented name. Folders are easy to drag and drop. You can move it forward, put it first, If you open a window and hover your cursor over this button, a Windows 11 feature appears. Snap layout. You can snap the window into any area of the screen. There should be a new version in 22H2. If you grab the window by the header and drag, this kind of curtain pops up from above. By sliding the window over it, you can do the same thing. Put the window on a part of the screen. If other windows are open as well, you will be prompted to select windows for free areas. The offer depends on what part of the window the user has selected. If he has selected half, the other window will be offered in half as well. If a quarter, the system will alternately suggest other open windows for each free quarter. In version 21H2, when you right-click on an object, file, or folder, a new Windows 11 context menu appears. If you select Show More Options, a classic context menu appears. A new feature should be added in 22H2. If you press and hold Shift and right-click on an object, the classic, long menu appears immediately. There is a new personalization setting in version 22H2. Selecting background. This drop-down listed three items: picture, solid color, and slideshow. In the new version, a Windows Spotlight item is planned. If you select it, this icon will appear on the desktop. With the new setting, the wallpaper will be updated automatically, daily. The wallpaper is taken from Bing. The icon allows you to open the pictured place on the site. Put a like or dislike. This item is if it allows you to go to the next picture. You've probably already seen how it works on the Windows Welcome screen. Now, the setup adds this kind of wallpaper to the main and all other desktops you work with. In Explorer version 21H2, there is no promise of adding tabs yet. Let's see what is expected here. If you open the Explorer options, there is a drop-down list. Open Explorer 2. In the previous version, here is Quick Access and this computer. Now here is Home, this PC. Home, very similar to Quick Access. I prefer this PC. I usually disable those items for myself. There are more of them, by the way. And on the View tab, I uncheck Hide File Extensions. I like it this way. You can reset the default settings here if you like. In Windows 11 libraries, folders have a preview effect. A closed folder gets the background of what's in the folder. To get a good view of this, I turn on Large Thumbnail View. I've only reviewed some updates, mostly visual, to the Windows 11 22H2 version. There are others. For example, a new system update deletion window, an updated task manager, new volume, brightness indicators, and some others. If you actively support this video, I'll record part 2. Thanks for watching my videos. If the video was useful, please like it. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends and family. Please share it with them. Subscribe to the channel if you have not yet. Turn on the bell so as not to miss new videos. I wish health to all viewers. It was a tutor. See you soon.